Focus, damn you. The lighting on this thing is just not great, is it? Why am I this colour? Hi, anyway. I've made it to the airport. I'm at the airport. All the emotions have gone. I'm no longer emotional. I said goodbye to Rosemary. Got a little bit emotional in the car. And like, not bad emotional, it's just like so much love. Yeah, it's just a big change. But yeah, say goodbye to Rosemary, and then like now I'm comfortable in airports. So I'm sat in a bar by myself. And I'm just on my laptop. So my gate doesn't show until 5:30, so it's 4 now, so I've got time to just sit and chill. I'm in Terminal 3 in like section A, really small, and there's basically all the shops are just designer shops. So yeah, I'm just going to sit, have a drink, chill. And then I found out that for my connection, I don't have to recheck in, I just have to get... Just have to get my bag from the conveyor belt and put it on the, what's it called? The transfer. The transfer belt is what I've been told. Which sounds a lot easier because the check-in was in a different terminal. So I'm feeling a lot better about that. And Rosemary came from like for the baggage with me and then left me at security. So that was nice. So yeah, it's happening. It's all good. Like, nothing but joy and excitement now. Really weird. Like, now that I'm here, it's all good. Maybe it'll be different on the plane. Probably not. I think I'm fine now. So let's see what happens. Okay, bye. That's my plane. That's my plane. I'm at the gate. How do I zoom out? Oh, that's a good photo, hey? Focus. I'm at the gate. I made it to the gate. I'm at the gate. I have no nerves at all now. Like, this is the easy bit. Like, I love flying. I love being in a plane. I feel like when you're in a plane, you can't do anything else. Like, it's the only thing you can do.
Welcome to the flight VH-137 to the ocean of Kennedy. We will be moving very shortly. In the meantime, any passengers who require any special assistance or extra special time boarding, passengers with children under the age of 4, so please come forward for boarding. Once we are ready for boarding,
there's like 20 people there.
By group number, which can be found on the bottom of your
phone. Okay, I'm going. I can't pay attention. I'm so glad that I filmed this whole process because where I was in, like,
in Lima, the capital. My first flight was perfect, could not have been better. I had three seats to myself. I was doing my little YouTube-y edits, and then I was just, had some food, had a sleep, it was stunning. Then I had to get off that flight. So that was 7 hours to JFK. Then at JFK, I had to get off, go through customs. The customs queue was 1.5 hours. It said it was going to be 45 minutes. It was a lie. So I'm in this queue and I had moved like one line in like 20 minutes, and so I'm starting to like itch because my layover was 2 hours and 55 minutes, so it was enough time, but not if there was a queue for 1.5 hours. So we had to go through security. We had to go through security, and then I had to get my checked-in bag, and because it was, I had to do the connection myself, if that makes sense. So I had to get the bag from one carousel thing and put it on another one to get it on the second plane. So I'm very aware of this, and then I know that I have to like get to the gate. So I'm in the queue, I'm stressing, and I'm thinking, okay, do I leave the queue and go and ask someone, even though I'm like, you know, I'm in this queue now, like I'm not at the end of the queue, I'm not in the middle of the queue, but I'm just like somewhere in between. And I'm thinking, right, if I risk leaving my space and I have to go to the back, then I'm definitely going to be late. So it was a bit like, yeah, I have to make a decision. And I was getting really like, I was trying to just chill myself out. I was just going like, it's all going to be fine. Like, no matter what, it's fine. Like, worst case, you miss your flight, you get another one, like, chill. But also, like, in the moment, it's never that chill, is it? So, yeah, I'm becoming a little bit more stressed. I'm looking around, seeing, like, when I get to the edge of the queue, if, like, someone who works at the airport walks past, and I can be like, excuse me. That didn't happen. Anyway, so starting to stress, starting to get agitated, and I'm just saying to myself, it's going to be fine. Everything works out for me, it's going to be fine, like, just chill, you can't do anything, it's all fine. And as I'm like saying this in my head, like over and over, like repetitive, it's fine, it's fine, it's fine, it's gonna be fine, everything always works out for me. The guy in front of me in the queue took his headphones off and started like looking around, and I was like, say something to me. I was just in my mind, I was going, yep, he's gonna say something, what's he gonna say, like just say it. And then he put his headphones back on and like walked a bit, but I could see he was getting like agitated as well. He also had sat behind me on the flight, the first flight, so he's getting agitated, puts his headphones back on, a couple more minutes, takes them off, and he like sighs and he's like looking around. So I'm like kind of looking in his direction to be like, make contact with me, like, just so he looked about my age, so I was just like, I'm here, like, you can talk to me. And he did. He basically was like, is it meant to take this long? And I said, I don't know. He was like, I've got a connecting flight. I was like, so do I. He was like, I'm going to Lima. I was like, so am I. And then we both were just like, oh my God, oh my God. It's just, I cannot tell you the relief when you are with someone is a madness. Like, traveling with someone is so chill compared to when you're on your own. It's wild. So yeah, we realized that we're on the same plane. The plane's gonna wait for us, it's gonna be fine, and then we can figure it all out together. It was like, oh my God. And he's been to Peru before, so I was asking him about Peru and like things he recommended. He's just coming back for 2 weeks to go around with his mate, but he's done basically all of Latin America before, so I was like, oh my God, and this and this and this. Yeah, so his name was Freddie, and he was like my guardian angel. Like, when he turned around and we found out that we were on the same flight, like, I cannot explain the happiness I felt. Just to be like with someone in that situation is just, it makes such a difference. Anyway, so we just chatting through security, which is just like taking our minds off of it anyway. He's from London, Freddie from London, I think he's 26, so we're just chatting. And yeah, we get to security. American security is scary. They scared me. Bear in mind, like, I've landed at midnight New York time, so it was like 4 a.m. No. 1 a.m.? No. What time was it? 4 a.m.? UK time? I don't know. It was in the middle of the night and I was tired. And he's like questioning me and I just didn't know the answers to the questions. And he was like, why did you hesitate? He was like, where are you coming from? And I hesitated and I was like, oh, London. And he was like, you have to think about that. Why did you hesitate? I was like, no, it's so early. Just be nice to me. I'm stressed. That was fine. Go through. So now it's me and Freddie against the world. So we find our bags because security had taken so long. Everyone had taken the bags off the carousel thing and they were just on the floor. So we grab our bags, big bags, on our backs, and we see the sign that says connecting flights, baggage drop. I think they were separate, maybe all together. It was like connecting flight underneath baggage drop. So we were like, yeah, that looks right. So we had to go out the exit and then we went round to the left and there was what looked like would be a baggage drop for Latam, which was who we were flying with. But there was no one there. It was closed. So then we asked someone and we were like, we've got our like checked in bags that are on a connecting flight. We need to drop them off so they can be on the next plane, you know, the transfer. And she was just like, you need to go to floor 4 and like check them in. And we were like, okay. So we went up to floor four and get there, like running across to like the Latam section bit. And the lady who's working there is like, it's closed, no one's there. And we're like, what do you mean? She's like, it's closed, no one's there, you can't drop a bag. And we were like, what? But what do we do? And she was like, it's closed. And wasn't giving a solution, she was just like, it's closed. So I was like, right, okay. It's like, let's go back to the conveyor belts. There might be like a separate conveyor belt for transfers. Like we might just need to put on a conveyor belt. So we go back and security are like shouting at us like, no, stop, you can't come here, this is the exit. And I was just like on the verge of crying. I was like, what? Bear in mind, I'm carrying my big bag on my back, my small bag, which is pretty big anyway. So my big bag is 14 kg and my small bag is like 7 kg. I'm sweating, like we're running about this airport. I'm running with like 20 kg on my back. Disgusting. And it's the middle of the night. So yeah, we're running around, security men are shouting at us, and then we're like, what do we do? Like, where do we take these bags? And they were just like talking amongst themselves and like they're just really scary. They just weren't being overly friendly, but basically they were just like, just take them to the gate, because I like, we've got tags on them that says like end destination Lima, they're checked in, they're transferred, blah blah blah. He was just like, take them to the gate. And we're going to the gate and I'm going, this can't be right, this is not right, like to the gate with my big bag, are you mad? So we get to like the security, so I have to then check my big bag through the security, you know where you like take your liquids out, through that. So I'm going, oh my god, it's not gonna fit in the tray, it's gonna be too big, they're not gonna accept it, like what do I do? I had so many liquids in that bag as well, because obviously like I had separated the ones in my carry-on, but I've got loads of liquids in the other one, and like I hadn't had the time to like sort them out. So I was like, oh my god, what do I do? Freddie ended up just binning his big liquids. He was just like, we need to go, like now. Like he binned all of his, because he had like big bottles. All of mine, luckily, were under 100 milliliters, I think. But I only had one clear bag and it was already basically full. So I just left my liquids in the bag and just was like, let's just see how it goes. I finished like my drink that was in this and just chugged that. So yeah, actually got through that fine, like my bag fit in the tray, the liquids didn't come up funny, like walked through security fine. He, bless him, he went through before me and he like grabbed my stuff because I had to walk through the thing up a couple of times. Honestly, I'm so happy that he was there. Otherwise I would have just been a mess, like actual mess. Like we were both stressed, but because we were both stressed, it was just like, it's fine, it's fine. But we said to each other after, like, we both thought that we weren't making the flight. So we get through security, gate had already been announced, obviously. Well, not obviously, but it had. So then we've got bags on and we are running through the airport. Do you know how hard it is to run with 20 kg on your back? And it's not even just the weight, it's like the, yeah, anyway, I'm actually dripping in sweat. I stink. I'm like on the verge of crying. Also, I didn't have time to put my liquids back in my bag or my laptop back in my bag. So I had big backpack, little backpack, bum bag, liquids, laptop, and I'm running. And then we just, the audacity of us, we stopped to fill up our water bottles because we had to chug our water bottles and then thought, like, we're not going to have water for ages. So we stopped, like, filled up our water bottles. It was a 20-minute run to the gate. got there, everyone boarded. And then the lady's like, she obviously needs to scan my passport. I don't have any free hands. My passport's in my bum bag. It's all very inconvenient. But basically, yeah, in the end, get it through, get on the plane. Everyone's all sat down, like, everyone sat down. Also, what's really funny is that he was meant to be sat on the seat in front of me, and I was sat behind him, but because we were the last people on, someone had sat in his seat, and which was really lucky because he was in, there's like three, I think it was two, three, three. He was in the middle of the middle three. But someone had sat in his seat, so I had a full row behind me free, so my seat was like the aisle seat in the middle three, and so it was me, space, and then he sat here, which was really good. Like, we didn't speak the whole flight, but it was just nice to be like, we did this. Like, when we got on the, oh, so anyway, bags, carrying the bags on, I'm going, there's no fucking way, everyone's already seated, all the overhead lockers are full, all of them are full. All of them are full, and I've got my big fucking, it's like, I think it's 50 liters plus 20 liters or something like that, and his was 65 ish but his was a lot less full than mine because he's only coming for 2 weeks. So I'm just like hollering at the flight attendant, like, hi, my bag, it needs to fit, help me. One, I can't lift it above my head, couldn't lift it into the locker thing. So I get the flight attendant, I'm like, I just basically looked like I was gonna cry at him until he made it work, and he did, bless him, he like moved things around and he got it in. I don't know how we got it in, like, it was a miracle, like, because Freddie's got put in straight away and it was just mine left for ages, and I was like, everyone else on the plane was sat down and it was just me stood up. Also, like, on that flight, no one spoke a word of English, everyone was speaking Spanish. I was like, oh my god. But yeah, so yeah, it went up in the end. Me and Freddie sat down and we just were like, oh my god, thank you so much for being there for me with that. Yeah, and we were just so happy, like, we can't believe we made that flight. Like, it was honestly, it was a miracle, and like, I'm so glad that, like, honestly, guardian angel, like, what the hell. And he like felt the same with me as well, like, wow, we both just needed each other. Like, the fact that he turned around to speak to me, I was on the same flight as him, not only the same flight, I was sat one row behind him, like, crazy. And then, like, when we got off as well, he, bless him, got my bag down for me because I couldn't fucking do it. And then because we already had our bags, we literally just had to walk through security and we didn't have to wait for the baggage reclaim to come out, so that was good. And then my taxi was already waiting for me. Sure, gave him a hug and I said, bye Freddie, good luck. But like, honestly, that was so nice. And my message, he gave me his number, because he's going to be in Cusco in a couple of weeks, so if I'm there, I'm going to let him know, but I might just message him and be like, Thank you for your support. Crazy to big up Freddie, because I would not be here if it wasn't for him, to be honest with you. Anyway, so now I'm having a coffee. This is my second coffee. Having a coffee, I've got my Kindle, I'm not reading it. And I've booked in for a walking tour at 10. So I've got 40 minutes to just chill. I've checked into my room, which is really nice. I've got a top bunk. It's fine, but there was lots of people sleeping in that, so I didn't want to stay in there, basically. So yeah, that's where we're at. I'm going to go do the walking tour of Lima, and I'm not sure there's much else going on here, so we'll see. Okay, I will update you soon. Goodbye. You're crazy!
Okay, but that looks cool.
It does look cool.
Poor little babe. Go away.
No, thank you.
Go away. Go away.
On the waves looks so nice.
I have these ones
I know I wouldn't pay for it.
From the